Hi there, and let's get to it. Today we're looking at the basics of editing inside of DaVinci Resolve 12. I've imported some clips, and I've synced the audio based on their waveforms, and now I can proceed to the edit page to start working on them. So let's go over the complete basics. First of all, to select the clip, you can single-click it, and an orange outline will tell you that the clip is currently active. You can double-click a clip to reveal it in the source viewer, and you can preview the clip by clicking and dragging the jog bar at the bottom. You can use the play, stop, and playback buttons underneath. If you want to go for a classic editing workflow, you should be using the JKL shortcuts. L plays forward, K stops, and J plays backwards. The cool thing is pressing J or L multiple times speeds up your clip. So pressing L twice will fast forward it. Pressing L again will triple play it forward, and then pressing it four times is the maximum, is four times speed. Next, we look at in and out points. You can drop them in using the in and out shortcuts in the bottom right hand corner of the source viewer. And I am now indicating the portion of the clip that I want to use. Faster than that are the keyboard shortcuts. So I'm going to click X to remove these in and out points. And then I'm going to click I to drop an in point, L to play the clip forward, K to stop, and O to drop an out point. You can jump between in and out points by holding Shift and clicking I and O. So we're just about ready to take a look at a few editing methods. The first form of editing is simply called drag and drop editing. Once you indicate your in and out points, you click on the clip inside of the source viewer and drag it down to the timeline. Notice that as soon as the clip appeared, so did the timeline controls. So I now have an indicated video and audio one tracks. I can keep doing this. So double click another clip and use my JKL keys to play forwards, K to stop, I for an endpoint, L to fast forward, J to play backwards, O for an out point, and once again I can click and drag this clip next to the previous clip. Together with drag and dropping, I can also use the insert and overwrite buttons inside of the toolset. So if I go back to the very beginning and I use Control Plus to zoom in, if I choose to insert the clip, what it will do is non-destructive. It will insert the clip at the beginning of the timeline and move everything that comes after the playhead off to the right. If I undo and I choose to overwrite the clip instead, what's going to happen is the clip is going to just bulldoze over that area and place itself directly on top of the footage. In the next tutorial, we'll be looking at how we can use the track controls to manipulate inserting and overwriting. But in the meantime, let's take a look at the tracks themselves. First of all, we have a destination option in front of each audio and video track. That's you indicating which track you want to be active for receiving inserts and overwrites from the source monitor. Next to that, you have the name of the track. By default, they're just going to be naming themselves after their order, video 1, 2, 3, etc. But you could choose to click on this and type in a new name for the track. Underneath that, we have a few more controls. You have the enable button that allows you to temporarily hide a track if you don't want to see it. You have a lock that allows you to lock the clips in place, and that prevents them from being accidentally moved around. In this case, my audio is still changing, so I'd have to lock that too. And lastly, I've got this auto selection button, which we'll be looking at in more detail, but basically it either makes the clips active or inactive for certain operations that you're going to be performing with the playhead. Thank you very much for watching, and until next time.